Welcome to the presentation of static analysis of Java Enterprise applications. We are going to discuss a couple of things that make Java Enterprise applications interesting and can be improved in terms of static analysis. The first one is the use of enterprise application frameworks, and it affects the completeness of the analysis. And the second one is the use of CASIs, central data structures we can optimize to improve analysis scalability. And we call these two things the elephants in the room. This is joint work of Anastasios Antoniadis, Nikos Filippakis, Paddy Krishnan, Raghavendra Ramesh, Nick Allen, and Yannis Maragdakis. Enterprise applications are the biggest success domain of Java. Java dominates the domain of enterprise applications. Java is the king of enterprise applications. Anything that runs behind the server most likely contains Java code at some point. At the same time, academic research has produced excellent frameworks for the static analysis of Java. So one would expect that by combining the two, the Java enterprise applications and the static analysis frameworks, wonderful things like Suite, Walla, or Dupe, we would get high quality analysis for Java enterprise applications. However, this is very far from the truth. In fact, this is a major failure of Java static analysis framework. They fail to support Java enterprise applications out of the box. They don't model entry points, and they cannot even find where the application starts. So they gain very little completeness, and we do not know how they fare in terms of precision and scalability. But there are some roadblocks there as well, and we will try to address them in this talk. So the greatest challenge for static analysis of Java enterprise applications is completeness. This comes down to the enormous engineering complexity of these applications. Java enterprise applications are built on top of web frameworks. And you can see some familiar buzzwords here like Spring, Hibernate, or JDBC. Web frameworks use dynamic techniques and rely on external sources to achieve high customizability. They use techniques like dependency injection to achieve inversion of control. And this means that most of the essence of the application is not encoded within the Java code itself, but rather on these external sources. So one would need to model all this extra linguistic information in order to get an analysis with very high completeness. A typical static analysis does not even know where to start the analysis from. It gets confused while still trying to find the entry points to the application itself. Another challenge for the static analysis of Java enterprise applications is something that we discovered through the course of this work. That is the use of CASIs, central data structures used primarily for caching beans, views, or database objects. These CASIs rely on the use of Java util maps. And as it turns out, maps are an incredible challenge for even the most precise analysis. The analysis fails to model the flow of values through maps, it gets confused, loses precision, and thus scalability. To overcome these problems, we introduced Jackie. Jackie is a static analysis framework for Java enterprise applications. It provides a vocabulary that models the behavior of the frameworks, and it's easily extendable to support more frameworks. A result of our modeling of web frameworks is a very high completeness of 58% for a set of very large representative benchmarks. To understand how impressive this is, it rivals what we get for plain old vanilla benchmarks, like the Dacapo benchmarks, which consist mostly of desktop applications, and for which the analysis completeness is 43%. So Jackie goes even higher than that on far more complex benchmarks. The second aspect of our work is the sound modulo analysis modeling of data structures. And this modeling aims to maintain the precision of the analysis within these data structures and has successfully given us a 6 times faster analysis on average for our benchmarks. And finally, we have evaluated Jackie on popular real-world benchmarks that are very representative. So the first aspect of our work is completeness. Jackie offers a vocabulary to describe what frameworks do. We have used this vocabulary to model web frameworks, and you can use it to extend this modeling. This vocabulary describes what frameworks do in terms of points to analysis, such as entry points to the application and the interconnection of bin objects. It is a vocabulary that provides general terms that describe framework-specific elements with common functionality. And now let me give you an idea of this vocabulary. It contains general common Java enterprise terms like servlet, controller, interceptor, or bin. And it also contains variations of these terms like entry points or bin field injections, which encode valuable points to analysis concepts. We provide this vocabulary and you can use it to model the behavior of frameworks. So we use our vocabulary in declarative rules, as Jackie is a declarative framework built on top of another declarative framework, Dupe. The discovery of entry points happens from aspects observed from the code, such as subtyping or annotations. In this case, we mark a class as servlet if it's a concrete application class and is a subtype of the generic servlet class. At the same time, we also process external sources like XML files in order to identify entry points. So these declarative rules are the key to gaining completeness, as they describe deeper and deeper concepts like dependency injection patterns through XML or annotations. And for instance, here we have a rule that identifies a field injection using annotations. And then we have a second rule that performs the linking between objects by associating the field injection with the values of a specific class and inferring points to information. And this modeling is not a shallow one. There is a deep recursive nature to the relationship of Jackie and the points to analysis. So here I will showcase a rule that connects the two. If we have a get bin invocation and its actual parameter points to a bin ID, and that points to information, and that bin ID is associated with a bin, and that bin has a generated object, bin object, and finally, the invocation assigns its return value to a local variable, we can infer that that local variable will point to the bin object. In this case, bin will point to the generated bin object get bin returns us. So by writing rules like this, we can get fairly complete modeling of Java enterprise applications. And now on to the next challenge of our analysis. During the course of this work, we observed that even the most precise analysis, the two object sensitive plus heap analysis, has a blow up of points to computation while analyzing maps, while the rest of the application takes much less time. So even for a benchmark like Alfresco, we observed that 72% of the time is spent for analyzing Java maps, and only 28% of the time is spent for analyzing the application. And as you will see, this trend goes along with all our benchmarks. So this comes down to the internal complexity of maps, and it's something that we want to remove. At the same time, this loss of scalability means also a loss of precision. And what we identified is that Java util maps feature a dubdispatch-like pattern. So in this case, we have the putval method of hasmap, which at first is called with the map itself as a receiver. But then the putTreeval method is called with a tree node as a receiver, and now the map is passed as a parameter to this method. So this pattern greatly degrades the precision of even the most precise analysis, like the two object sensitive analysis. And now let's see what effectively happens, and you can look into it with more detail in the paper. So the putval method is called with an information-rich context, which contains the hasmap object itself and the receiver of the allocating method of the hasmap object. And these contexts differentiate dynamic behaviors. And then the put tree valve method is called with the tree node object as the receiver. And that's the first part of our context. And the second part is the receiver of its allocating method, which is the HasMap object itself. And here, the receiver is the same for every single invocation of put tree valve, as the tree node object is an object local to the map. So in this case, points two sets will be merged. And here is where we lose precision. To overcome these challenges, we introduce the sound module analysis modeling of central data structures. And the idea is replacing central data structures with simplified models without losing precision. And as a matter of fact, in our case, we maintain precision and get even better precision at times. To give you a more methodical definition of this, given an analysis S and a code entity C, then C prime is the sound module analysis modeling of C if the S of C prime models all the dynamic realizable behaviors of C. That doesn't mean that C prime can replace C in all respects, but everything that is actual behavior and not an over-approximation of the analysis is modeled by C prime. And then by replacing C with C prime, we can get both a more or less precise analysis for C under fixed S. We can get a more precise analysis if we simplify specific behaviors to help context sensitivity do a better job, or we can get a less precise analysis in case where we merge behaviors and model things in a more broad manner. So here is an example of how this modeling works. We replace references to arrays with references to single nodes here, and then we replace the iteration here with an over-approximation of it. And this over-approximation assigns e.next to itself. So one would expect that this modeling is less precise, but in practice it is not, because our analysis is array insensitive. It does not model locations within the maps. So we model more coarsely something that doesn't really matter. So this simplification gives us more precision as a matter of fact. And also what we do here is we maintain information exceptions to keep the analysis sound. So that's the intuition of sound module analysis modeling. We capture all the original behaviors, we try to remove complexity, and the greatest complexity removal factor is the treeification elimination. The treeification converts the map bins to red-black trees, and this is a different backend that the analysis does not really need to reason for in terms of how the objects flow through the map and get back to the application. So it's completely unnecessary for our analysis. And finally, let me guide you through our evaluation. Our evaluation consists of three axes: completeness, speed, and precision. So we evaluated Jackie on a set of real world, realistic, very large, and used applications. These applications have thousands of stars on GitHub, hundreds of forks, and our benchmarking suite contains content management systems, e-commerce frameworks, website building frameworks, and we think it's an excellent suite for evaluating future work. So Jackie comes with impressive completeness that rivals the one that's even higher than the one for plain old DaCapo benchmarks, which are very well researched and very well established and are used in many Java static analysis community papers. So for DaCapo, we get 43% completeness, while Jackie achieves an impressive 58%. In fact, Jackie takes us from these yellow lines here to right to the end of the olive green lines here. In terms of speed, Jackie takes us from these high columns here to these much lower ones here. And the average speed up, if you crunch down the numbers, is 6x by replacing just three classes in the library. It even makes benchmarks that would not terminate with the original JDK terminate with a sound module analysis JDK. And our techniques do not harm precision. In fact, we see improvement in several metrics where lower is better, such as average var points to size or call graph edges. And you can find even more metrics in our paper. To conclude, we presented Jackie. Jackie is a declarative and extendable framework that provides a complete vocabulary for modeling frameworks. And it comes with an impressive completeness out of the box. Also, our sound modular analysis modeling of maps maintains soundness while achieving very high scalability and significantly improving precision. And cut.